Hi there, and welcome to the Clever Road Studio. It's the next episode in our series all about apps. Keep watching. We've prepared a very informative video for you. In this episode, we'll be telling you about cloud-based app development with the use of BaaS. First of all, what is BaaS? It is backend as a service. These services were created in order to reduce the time working with the backend applications. Typically, using such services, you will have a set of ready-made APIs and SDKs. The set of basic backend functions includes the following: push notifications, cloud storage, integration with social networks, and analytics. There is also server-side code, user administration, SDKs for popular platforms, background tasks, and error analytics. Each of them has its own API, which should be implemented into an application. Building cloud applications greatly simplifies the process. We have found some pros and cons of using cloud services. Let's start with the advantages. The first one is for the data storage control panel. With this panel, it's possible to create, edit, and view elements. The second plus is the price of usage. A lot of services provide a trial period or a basic set of functions for free. The third one is the cost of development. With the use of cloud services, you can reduce your expenditure because this kind of development requires less time. You should already know that time is money when it comes to the cost of app creation. If not, then see our video that covers the issue, how much does it cost to create an app? There are three more advantages of using cloud-based development. It is fast-paced, simple, and easy to scale. Let's move on. There are also some disadvantages. The first one is the risk of code damage. Some cloud services provide code protection, so take that into account when choosing. The second problem regards restrictions. There are some strict rules for such service usage, and it is difficult to get around them. The next issue is the risk of data loss. There is the possibility of damage or even closure of the service you are using. If the service is closed, there may be some tools to move your app to another server. But if the service is suddenly damaged, you can lose your app entirely. Also, there are some difficulties with testing when using such services because of coding access problems. The final disadvantage is about the size of your project. If it is a very large BaaS, cloud services may not be suitable for you. Also, it is worth mentioning that there is no need to write server-side code. Everything is done by the SDK requests in an application. It is both a plus and minus at the same time. The disadvantage is that in order to change the behavior of the server-side, it is necessary to update the application, which can be a difficulty in the case of cross-platform applications. If you don't want to use cloud-based services, we have two alternatives for you. The first one is to use the server-side technology and thus create your own backend and store it on your own server. But there is one thing to remember. If your application is ready to be the next Facebook or Instagram, spending on the maintenance of your own server will be enormous in comparison to cloud app development. The second option is to create your own backend and use cloud application hosting. This option is more time consuming, but it does eliminate some of the risks associated with BaaS development. Such applications are easier to test and there are fewer restrictions for the developer. So, going back to the main question about whether cloud-based services are right for you or not, well, having considered all the pros and cons, it can be concluded that a better question would be, which one do I need? But be careful with your choice and take into account all your requirements. Well, that's all for today. If you still have some questions, read the full article or just contact us and we'll answer all your questions. Stay with us and subscribe to our channel. See you next time.